What we're gonna do right here is go back, way back, back into time.
What's up, everybody? My name is Leslie Gibbs. I lived in Red Hook all my life, from 1957 up to present. Never left Red Hook. Growing up around West 9th Street. That's where my DJ career started at. Actually, my music career started around West 9th Street. In front of 21 Mill Street. One day, my mother was throwing out a floor model TV. And you know, back then, them floor model TVs came with a turntable and a stereo on the side. So I took the turntable out. I was about 7 or 8 years old. I remember building a box for it. And we had an 8-track player that they wasn't using. And I used that, and I got a couple of 8-tracks and a couple of 45s. Went outside one day and played outside in front of 21 Mill Street. And everybody loved it. And I loved what I was doing to everybody. And that's what started my DJ career. Growing up around West 9th Street, my last name is Gibbs, and we had another Gibbs family that lived in our building on the 5th floor. We had Harry Gibbs, we had Gloria Gibbs, we had Mary Gibbs, Tiny Gibbs. Y'all know them. We had the Clark family living in our building. June Clark, Vincent Clark, rest in peace. Robbie Clark, rest in peace. Audrey Clark, rest in peace. On the first floor, we had the Burroughs family. Squeaky Burroughs and Debbie Burroughs, rest in peace. And Georgia, rest in peace. And Keith Burroughs, and everybody knows them. So we had a lot of fun growing up around West 9th Street. We had a lot of family around there. We had the older guys like John Moore and Brother Jones, the Jones family from the second floor. We always had Crazy Gerald lived around our block. He still lives around there. He's still one of the coolest guys out there. He loved kids, Crazy Gerald. We used to play wiffle ball around the block and buck buck. And while everybody was doing that, I was playing music outside. Lovely moments. In my teenage years, I moved around Peyton Place. And that's when my DJ career really started flourishing then. This is going out to my girl, Dalia Garnes. I always like to say Dalia. Just wanted to give you my little Red Hook moment. Maybe we need to put some more time on it next time. It's your boy, the Chief Rocker. Peace.
Hi, my name is James Samuel, and I grew up in Red Hook from 1969 through 2003. My fondest memories of growing up in Red Hook have to be, I would say, the summer of 78, when the Disco Enforcers, Leslie G, DJ Amar, the Golden Voice of Fast, MC Desire, went out to Coffee Park and would just rock for hours and hours. To me, that was my fondest memories of growing up in Red Hook. Thank you.
Hey, hey now, this is Vivian Slaughter. I've been a resident of Red Hook from 1966 to 2012. One of my fondest memories of growing up in Red Hook was the love and the unity in the community. Also, we had a block party on a block we had grew up on, which was Columbia and Lorraine, right across from the liquor store, the bar, the pharmacy, the medical center. And DJ Leslie G and his crew, the Disco Enforcers, they built the stage. And the block party was awesome. Myself, Robin Jones, Rowena Jones, and Bernadette Garnett, we did a dance. And the community cheered us on. And when we were finished, they gave us hugs and was saying good job. Leslie was giving us shout outs for the rest of the night on the mic. And another one was when we got a little older, we were able to attend the jams in Coffee Park, which was awesome. Like, we could rock out until 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning with no drama. And I remember Iniquity and Fast and Desire on the mic, Leslie G, Easy G, Junie D on the turntables. One of the raps that stand out in my head was Fast, Straight Down, Do the Jerk, Let Me See Your Body Work, Slam Dunk, Feel the Funk, Come On Y'all, We Got the Rump. I mean, it was just awesome. It was just really, really awesome. And I hope you all have fond memories of growing up there. There's no other community like ours. I've been to other neighborhoods, other projects, to where people didn't even know their neighbors. And we are blessed to have grown up in a community like Red Hook. God bless you all.
My name is Danette Franqui, also known as Danette Vigilante. I was born and raised in Red Hook, so that's from 1963. Yeah, I just told you the year I was born. Through the mid-1980s. One of my favorite memories of growing up in Red Hook, I'd have to say, is having picnics beneath huge, gorgeous trees that were outside my building, 16 Mill Street. My best friend and I would pack up our peanut butter and jelly sandwiches and a blanket and hang out beneath those trees all day. And then one time we came home from school to find that housing or whoever made the decision to knock down those gorgeous trees and replace them with basketball hoops. It was a terrible, terrible day. We had no warning, and we missed those trees. We really, really did.
Hi, my name is Chriselle Morales. I was born and raised in Red Hook since 1964 to 1982. I have many, many wonderful memories growing up in Red Hook. I remember this one time, in 1977, I was hanging out in the back where Fairway is today. I remember when the lights went out. It was crazy. It was me, my sister Emily, also known as Baby. It was Samada Gonzalez. May she rest in peace. Rest in peace. Her name was, she was known to be called Blondie in the neighborhood. Knew many, many people. Well, we're back there getting into trouble, doing things that we shouldn't be doing. The lights go out. Pitch black. Couldn't see one another. We start calling out to one another, trying to grab hold of everyone. I get my sister, I have my sister's hand. Samada screaming and yelling. I reach her. As we try to make our way through the streets, we couldn't see a thing. Here's someone coming down the road with a car. You could see the lights. He spotted us. He takes us into the car. As he went through the streets, he was just going around picking up young kids. We were all over the streets, no lights. Couldn't see where we were going. But this guy came and saved our life and rescued us. That's what Red Hook was all about. Families coming together. People going out and taking care of each other's kids. Those are the great memories I have about Red Hook.
What up, everybody? This is your girl, Gina. Better known as Gina Jean. Really known as Eugenia Follins. I was born in 82 Dwight Street. Well, really, I was born in 135 Richard Street. Moved to 82 Dwight Street on my first birthday. I was born in 1966. I lived in Red Hook until 1991, where I moved to Ohio, where I'm residing at right now. I'm the fifth child and the only girl to the Follins family. My fondest memories of New York, listening to this song, Boogie Oogie Oogie, it would have to be the jams in Coffee Park, no doubt. I remember us all having a good time partying, dancing, hustling, doing what we do, drinking and smoking. Of course, I wasn't back then. I was just a little tad bit, you know. But I just remember having a whole lot of fun in the jams, you know, thanks to Leslie G and the Disco Enforcers and, you know, all of those. I really appreciate my time in Red Hook. Red Hook has taught me a lot, and I really miss Red Hook a lot as well. I miss all my old friends and family and everybody, I want to thank Delia for putting this Red Hook alumni page together so I can stay in touch with my Red Hook people. It's nothing like Red Hook. My brother Todd always say that he's been to many projects, but there's no family like Red Hook family, and I have to tend to agree with him with that. Again, Delia, I thank you for everything that you do for us Red Hookians, and keep up the good work. God bless everybody, and everybody be safe.
Hi, my name is Robert McCray, better known in the neighborhood as Fish. I lived in Red Hook from 1966 to about 1982. I enjoyed the community immensely. One of my fondest memories were that I attended PS 15, and during the winter, when it would snow, snow would cover the basketball court and schoolyard. Myself, Larry Hooker, James Hodges, Dee Dee, Perry Barnes, you know, we'd all play basketball in the morning. But in order to play basketball, we first had to borrow a shovel from the custodial engineer by the name of Caesar at PS 15. We cleared the snow away from the basketball court, and we commenced playing about 20, 25 minutes before school started. Man, we had a great time. We'd all pretend that we were one of the Knicks. I was Earl Monroe. Larry Hooker was Willis Reed. James Hodges was Dave DeBuscher. Dee Dee was Mike Reardon. Or whoever was on the Knicks to be extra. And we played all that morning and had a good time before school started. When the weather got a little nicer in the spring, we'd move over to punch ball and play punch ball before school started. That was some serious activity for us before school started. Got us pumping. It was a great time back then. I really enjoyed it. I'm Fish, and that was my Red Hook memory.
My name is Lloyd Solomon, and I lived in Red Hook from 1955 until 1973, until when I joined the Navy. However, my family remained in Red Hook. There were a lot of well-known families in 811 Hick Street other than mine. For instance, we had the Bennetts, the Cooks, the Lastras, the Graves, the Jacksons, the Garretts, just to name a few. My happy moment was while playing basketball for Mikio, my team won the citywide basketball championship in 1969 and 1970, which no one in Red Hook can claim. My inner circle of friends were Todd Wilson, Glenn Rogers, Ricky Free, Patrick Williams, the Barty girls, Camilla Dula, Yvette Jarvis, Shawnette Wilson, and my girl Bunny Mack. Of course, there are more happy moments, so in summation, my whole time in Red Hook were very happy moments.
Hi, my name is Carl Campbell. I was born and raised in Red Hook, born in 1965 on Columbia Street, building 416. Some of the families that I grew up with that I can remember were the Bernards, the G's, the Russells, the Smiths, the Murrays, the Berries, the Williams, the Walkers. You know, it was like, let me see, 5 buildings, so it was a lot of people, and I can't remember them all. But just some of them are just off of the top of my head. Some of the fondest memories I have about growing up on Columbia Street, which is called the Ave, is when we used to have block parties with the Disco Enforcers, Leslie G and Amar. They would come out and play music, and it seemed like it always brought the block together, especially when we wasn't doing anything, and it would just say, let's play some music, and, you know, always had a good time. There was no shootings, nothing like that. Had a just great time. Had a ball growing up on Columbia Street. So that's some of my memories that I have of Red Hook.
When I try to do without that I'm giving is for the love of you. All right now. Ooh, lovely as a ray of sun that touches me when the morning comes, feels good to me. My love and me. Well, smoother than a gentle breeze, flowing through my mind with ease, soft as can be. Well, when you're loving me, when you're loving me, love to be right in the way. Share it with your touch, and it seems to me we could sail together in and out of mystery. Well, I wanna be living for the love of you. All right now, all that I'm giving is for.
Hi, my name is Stephanie White, known as Stephanie Knight from Red Hook, and I moved there in 1968. I left Red Hook in 1993. I have one sister, Leslie, and one brother, Malcolm, and Wise is deceased. I used to hang out with Peggy Holly and Brenda Tripp. My best memories was sitting outside and playing spades all night long. Those were the best of times. Red Hook will always have a special place in my heart.
Hi, my name is Bobby Smith. My sister's name is Frida Smith Warfield. My brother's name is Carnell Smith. We grew up on Columbia Street from 1959 to 1982. My fondest memories of growing up in Red Hook involved like the summers when we all used to get together and work like summer youth corps. But the good thing about living on my block, which was like Columbia Street right across from the Arab store, I think they call it the Avenue now, but back then it was just Columbia Street across from the Arab store, is that we lived on a block where Miss Knight used to get us manpower jobs. Everybody else has summer youth corps, and manpower at the time paid like a little bit more. But every other Friday, we would all get together with our little manpower checks and roll down to Delancey Street. You had to roll down into the posse, because if you didn't, you might get ripped off. But yeah, I just remember those times with my boys. We would, you know, get together and go shop down Delancey Street. Good times, you know. To this day, you know, when people tell me where I'm from, I say, yo, I'm from Red Hook. I don't say Brooklyn, I say Red Hook. And I'm proud to be from Red Hook.
For those of you who don't know my face, I'm Fast Sister Bobo Hall from Peyton Place. Remembering only good times, can't think of any bad about growing up in Red Hook, which was really quite fab. There was Larson's Bakery, Del Fonte's in the back, Sal's at Crazy Corner, and Pablo's for my dad. We swam in the pool, played baseball in the field, kissed in Lover's Lane, just keeping it real. Those days I remember were really very fine, hanging out in those parks, coffee, tea, and wine, basketball and wine park, swings and sprinklers in the tea, music in the coffee park with Moose and Leslie G. Everything about the hook will forever stay with me. Life lessons learned surely molded me into this beautiful person that I turned out to be. Love y'all, Red Hook.
Hi, my name is Louise Conti. I lived in 815 Hicks Street, apartment 2B, from 1943 to the present time. All right, Dolores Chiara and I go back years. Every moment was special to us just hanging out in my house, of course, 815 Hicks Street, apartment 2B, listening to our records. In the summer on hot nights, we would be on the benches. Dolores Chiara, Joanne Miller, Loretta Nasira, Philip Navilla, George Franqui, Benny Elias, Manny Fernandez, and JoJo Blasfeld. My best moments were in the Red Hook Projects. We used to have a ball. Not like the kids today. Kids today, they really don't know what it's like to have fun like we did back in the day. So George Franqui and I, we wound up getting married, having three kids. We no longer live in the projects. We live down the point. And then we moved. Today, we're at the Columbia Street waterfront, where John's Bargain Store used to be, and Cheap Cheeps, and House of Pizza. So that's my life in Red Hook.
Hi. My name is June Paul, but everybody will remember me as June Stewart. I lived in Red Hook from 1958 to 1978 with my parents, Mr. Paul and Miss Thelma, and my two sisters, Paula and Pat, and my two brothers, Junior and Michael. My fondest memories of Red Hook are the summer nights playing outside while my mom and her friends, Miss Jeanette and Miss Nellie and Miss Dottie and Miss Alma, would be sitting on the benches, drinking Yago Sangria, laughing, listening to music, and Miss Brathaway's sons, Beaver and Steven, they would come outside and play the congas, and everybody would just be having a good time. We'd be running all over the block playing flashlight tag and Coco Livio, and everyone knows about the flagpole, that would be our base. We used to have a lot of block parties back then too, and all the neighbors would bring food, and all the kids would be dancing and having water balloon fights and playing music and dancing in the street. It was just a real fun time. We also used to have a lot of Halloween parties, and we had some other fun neighbors, the Colemans, and they had a lot of kids, Charmaine and Billy and Arlene and Zena, and we would decorate the building, and all the kids would have costumes, and we'd have candies, and it would just be a safe Halloween. Nobody would have to go trick-or-treating. We didn't have to worry about the kids. We also used to have Christmas parties in the building and decorate the doors like Christmas packages, and we just had a fun time in Red Hook. I don't regret any of the years that I was there. We had a good childhood, and I'm just glad I have a lot of great memories growing up in Red Hook. I wouldn't change it for anything, and I'm glad I got the chance and the opportunity to grow up like that and grow up in a time when neighbors were really neighbors. It was just a good experience for me.
Hi, my name is Monique Renault Corbin. Red Hook has been a part of me from birth. I lived in Red Hook from 1964 until 1984. The memories I have are so fond and so fun to think back about. One that comes to mind is learning to swim in a 16-foot pool. My mother could not swim, and she feared deep water, but she was determined that her girls would know how to swim. She had very little confidence in the lifeguards in the pool, so she devised her own method. She used the clothesline that you would normally use to hang clothes, and she tied the rope around our waist and tossed us out like fish bait. We would swim out, and when we got tired, we would tow the line, and she would pull us back in like we were a fresh catch. But I bet you we knew how to swim when it was all said and done. We had so much fun back then. And I should only hope and wish that the kids today could experience that same type of life that we had back in our childhood. Bye now.
Hey, this is John Fisher, born and raised in Red Hook, 1959. Finally moved out in 1985. Wow, the good times in Red Hook. I could go on forever. From Pier 27 trips to the Mickey O, to 142 to John Jay, Peyton Place, Coffee Park, the parties, the cookouts, 78 Set You Straight, the Ave, everything about Red Hook. One Way Out, baby.
Good morning, everybody. My name is George McCain. I grew up in Red Hook Projects from 1966 to about 1983. I believe I was 17 or 18 when I left Red Hook. I grew up on 811 Hicks Street, 79 Lorraine Street, and 426 Columbia Street, which is the Ave. And Junkie Paradise, which is 79 Lorraine, you know, I grew up with Wolfie, Carmelo's brother, the Wiggums family, the Browns family, which moved from Red Hook, Ronnie Harper, my man Tripp, used to live on the first floor, the Sterling's family, rest your soul, Tony, the Wise, Leroy, Malcolm, his brother, Steph, his sister, you know. Also, Junebug, the Junebug and them, Steven and Bay and all of them. I mean, the fun I had on that block with them, oh my God, irreplaceable. It's so irreplaceable. And Columbia Street, we had the Ave crew, you know, the Crockett's, the Campbells, Rodney Veeney, my family as well, the Fultons, Popper, Randolph, B.A., Isaiah Jones and everybody. I mean, we had a lot of fun growing up out there. And I remember one time we went to a beach. We went to Coney Island. We all got together and went to Coney Island. And that's where Randolph got his name B.A. from. His ass was drunk on the beach, and we called him Beach Alcoholic. And ever since then, the name stuck to him till this day. Okay, everyone. Y'all enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Love you.
My name is Gail McNally. I was born and raised in Red Hook. I was born in 1957. I left Red Hook in the 1980s. Good times and bad, Red Hook was the place to grow up. It carries memories that endure the best of times and the worst. The best time was when everybody was your mother and father. Everybody cared about what you did and why you were doing it. The worst of times was when I was at my lowest lows and let the community, amongst some other things, take over. But the bounce back was wonderful because the support that I got can never be replaced or forgotten. Yes, Red Hook is a small family that carries a big impact on your entire being. Growing up in Red Hook was the best thing that ever happened to me. Learning my rights and wrongs from Red Hook was the best thing that ever happened to me. It made me the most functional, strongest person I know, besides a few other good friends. With that being said, there's not a moment that I will ever forget about my legacy from Red Hook, and I am proud to be a part of it.
Joanne, and I lived in Red Hook from 1970 till about 1988. My sisters are Margie and Mumu, and we lived in 426 Columbia Street, apartment 4E. And the memories I have of living in Red Hook were when we had the seasons, and the seasons were Coco Livio, Skelly season, We had top season. We even had double dutch season. Just different seasons that would go, you know, during the months, the summer months when we were out of school. I also remember going to Red Hook Pool and squeezing through the bars to get in the pool without paying. I think it was like 15 cents to get in the pool. So rather than paying the 15 cents, we would sneak into the pool through the bars. And I also can remember when they played music in the park. And we would go to the park and just hang around. And I used to hustle with Cooley and the Chavises. Just all around good time growing up in Red Hook.
What's up, Red Hook Projects alumni? My name is Joe Hernandez. I'm a longtime Red Hook resident, born in 1971. I left in 2005. My best years was in Red Hook, of course. I grew up in the back on Van Brunt Street, Richards, and the rest of my years was in A11s, where I had the majority of my fun at. I miss Red Hook so much, and sometimes I just wish I could turn back the hands of time.
Hi, my name is Delia. I lived in Red Hook from 1967 to 1981. The best of times. My fondest memory is the pool. Red Hook Pool. Oh my God, the fee was only 25 cents, but we loved sneaking in. There was always a broken bar. We wedge ourselves through it. Millions of us. I don't know how they made money back then. I really don't. And yeah, we boldly went to change our clothes after we snuck in. Oh my God, they give us a wire basket. Open wire basket, no locks, no nothing. We put all our valuables in there. Jewelry, clothes, money. All they give us in return is an elastic band, and it had a metal round circle with the associated number to the wire basket. When we came out of that pool, we just give them our elastic band, and they'd give up everything back. Can we talk honest times? Oh my goodness, the floor was always water. Water was down there, gazillion germs. We never caught anything. Those were the best of times.
Hi, this is Calvin McNair, and this is my Red Hook story. I grew up in what they call junkie paradise because everybody used to come around there and get high. I was so glad when they dropped the junkie and they just called it the paradise. You may know my father, my brother. My brother was the blind guy that you would see my father always going to church up at New Brown Memorial with the blind son. And my mother was Evangelist McNair. She used to go back to Red Hook Gospel Assembly. Now, my sister Zenobia and Tony, you may know because Tony always hung out with Patty and Brenda and Beverly and Edna and, you know, like a little snot-nosed kid. I always had a crush on my older sister's friends, you know. Now, some of my friends you might know is Wayne Clayhorn, Milton Wade, and Craig Klinscale. Unfortunately, only Milton Wade, Craig, and myself were the only ones left. Unfortunately, you know, some came to a early demise, and I found a new group of guys to hang with. Most famously, everybody knew was DJ Moose. That was my main man. Unfortunately, he left us way too early also. And you might know Eddie Abnormal and, of course, Tinker Barfield. Tinker that plays bass with played bass with Luther Badros and Ashford and Simpson, one of my good friends. Some great thoughts was, you know, like the movies that we used to have, the Clinton movie up on Clinton Street, where you could go see a movie for, you know, 10, 15 cents, and the blockbusters you would have to pay either a quarter or, you know, 50 cents for, like the Ten Commandments or Ben-Hur. Then there was also the happy hour that was around on the other side of the Battery Tunnel, where it would cost as little as 2 or 3 cents to get no movies, but you have to watch yourself because you might have a little something nibbling at your toes. One other good thing I remember about the Clint movie was on Saturdays, 25 cents, you could watch all the cartoons that you wanted. You know, we love Sal's Icy's, and Nick's got me hooked on pastrami sandwiches. I went to Pier 27 until we made history and started getting busing out. And I went to PS 230. We were the first kids to get bussed out due to integration. After that, we went to PS 230 and then Montauk Junior High School. I graduated from FDR and I went to CCNY. Right now, I live in Flatbush and I'm retired from New York City Transit Authority after 35 years of service. That's my little Red Hook story. Thank you very much, and you have a pleasant day and a blessed life. Bye-bye.
My name is Rosa Garcia, and I came to Red Hook in 1964 at the age of 8. I have many fond memories of growing up here, going to the Mickey O, going to the Red Hook pool, Johnny Pumps playing Skellies, kickball, Larson's Bakery, Sal's Icy's. It was great. I still live here now, and I think I'll always live here. Growing up, I had one good friend. Her name was Joyce Sweeting, and we're still friends. I love my neighborhood, and I wouldn't live anywhere else but here in Red Hook, Brooklyn.
Hi, my name is Cassandra Walton from Nolloraine Street, Red Hook. I was born in 1960, and I left Red Hook in the year of 1996. And my fondest memories of living in Red Hook was when I used to talk to Elizabeth Sanabria on the third floor at 11 Lorraine Street on the telephone. We used to be looking out the window. All right, thank you.
Hi, Della. This is Josie, better known as Mumsy. I have lived in Red Hook since 1950 until present, and my fondest memory is hanging in the PAL. Their dances, they had sewing class, cooking class, dance class, anything you need, they had it. We had talent shows for the kids. When me and Portia worked there as some of you, and the pool. Oh, the pool was what's happening in the summertime. And the best thing that I remember, really, is the house parties. Oh, my God, they were the best. That's why I play this song for you and everybody in Red Hook, Home by Stephanie Mills, because I wish we can go back to them days when we had control over our kids. We didn't have to suck them dog bullets. And my friends were Clementine, Arrington, Belle, Socorro, Sandra Carter, Mary Taylor. We had such a good time. We never fought. No, we had arguments because all friends argue. But I really don't want to leave Red Hook. But one day I'm going to have to leave because I want to try to get me a condo to get out of here because this don't make no sense that the black is killing each other, and that's ridiculous. So I hope you like this little saying I have, but Red Hook was the best place to be back in the day. I mean, house parties every weekend, no fighting, no arguing, people getting along, go home together. I don't know what happened to Red Hook, but it's not the same. And I wish we can go back to them days where we all have fun and respect our parents and respect the elders. Today, we don't have that. But I pray to God that one day it will happen. Love you, Bella, and love you, my Red Hook family. Thank you. That's all my family in Red Hook. Family, friends, and those I love.
Peace. My name is Jamel Shabazz, and I was born and raised in Red Hook in 1960. I would spend 15 years out there from 1960 to 1975, some of the best days of my life. When I think of Red Hook, what comes to mind are the many families, large and small, that occupied the various buildings within my immediate circumference. We had the Fultons, the Rogers, the Johnsons, the Pattersons, Taylors, Campbells, Cutlers, Alvarezes, and the Mallorys, just to name a few. Red Hook was such a special place back then. We were so blessed to have Lawson's Bakery located right in the heart of the projects. On any given day, you could smell the sweet fragrance of fresh cinnamon and nutmeg, making Red Hook one of the sweetest smelling communities in Brooklyn. Red Hook was always prime real estate, surrounded by beautiful parks, both large and small. We had an Olympic-sized stadium overlooking the Gowanus Canal and a wonderful pool, along with the Mickey Center. I remember Columbia Street on Fridays and Saturday nights during the summer 1978. For us, this was the Ave. At times, it looked like 42nd Street. And there was Corfe Park, home to the Disco Enforcers. They mesmerized us with their talent. I think back of the brothers standing in their square building, while others guzzled down coarse old English. I remember the beautiful sisters passing us by, sipping pink champagne out of straws and brown bags. Regardless of the time and space, Red Hook will forever be a part of my heart. I want to take this moment and remember those who returned to the essence: Sabrina, Cheryl Jarvis, Guy and Sonata, Kevin Sands, and so many others. Peace.
Hello, Red Hook family. My name is Dave Colding, and I'm from 15 Bush Street, Apartment 5B, the extension of the Poor Block. And our neighborhood was also known as Welfare Island. And I'm the youngest of five kids. My brothers Freddie and Danny, and my sisters Joyce, and the one my father used to call the little guy, Cookie. Cookie. Yes, so anyway, I have some good memories, some bad memories, but some good memories of PS30. Just being there and being a kid, first grade all the way up to fifth, and I had a year at PS15. I remember in PS30, I went to the portable there in the fifth grade, and which was okay, I guess. And 142, of course, and also the good things there, like the good things growing up, just going to Nick's to get some sandwiches, some nice heroes, Sal's, Icy's, and just being a kid in front of 15 and 11 Bush Street and other places in Red Hook, but especially around my neighborhood, or I should say our court, playing Coco Livio and Stoop Ball and Punch Ball and just being a kid. And also my many good friends, Roddy Richardson, also known as Sonny, Rawson Nelson, also known as Boo Boo, Alvin Jones, Jeffrey Mitchell, Keith Warfield, and Yolanda Woolley, Vanessa Leocadio, Patsy Howard, many of people, Ellen Moran, Josephine Gagliardo, many of people I used to know, Pre Smith, Cheryl Breland, Cassandra Alexander, so many. You know, the big park, the little park, the monkey bars in the little park, and things like that. The stadium, many a track meet, and the pool period, the Clinton Street Theater, Larson's Bakery, so many places. Just running in the back, me and the guys running in the back, running in the abandoned factories, getting into trouble, and almost getting into trouble, you know. But good memories, I should say, pretty good memories. I'm happy and proud to be a product and a member of Red Hook Projects and Red Hook Projects alumni. Thank you.
between these. I was born in 1956. We moved to Red Hook 2 weeks prior to my birth, and my family left in 85. Some of my fondest memories are the barbecues that were held by my family in Lover's Lane. I also enjoy going to the pool. I enjoy going to all of the parks because recreation was a big thing in Red Hook for children, and we had a good time in comparison to what some of the children may be experiencing now. Hoping that Red Hook will go back to some of those happy days that I had.
Hi, I'm Elba Rosario, and I lived in Red Hook from 1958 to 1975. My building was 829 Hicks Street. I remember the people there, especially my next door neighbors, Joe, Freddie, Jimmy, Coco, Lucy, Morales family. Oh, and on the second floor, let's not forget Vincent and Ike Gill. Evie and Kuka and Junior on the third floor. And on the first floor, the Lopez family. I'm going to name the girls Carmen, Betty, Patricia, and Jackie. May she rest in peace, Jackie. I remember playing outside, skelzies, roller skating, riding bike, especially my handball as I got to a teenager. My favorite music was listening to Barry White, Teddy Pendergrass, the Jackson 5, Diana Ross and the Supremes. Wow, those memories were great. That music was awesome. I went to PS 27s and then 142 Junior High School, and I graduated from Sarah J. Hale. My best memory is my mom and my dad, Antonia and Jose Ortiz, my sisters Evelyn and Nancy, all living together as one. Oh, can I bring those memories back? I just cry just thinking about them. Anyway, let's keep this real. Good memories, right? I still visit Red Hook every now and then. I still have family there, and I try to make all my Red Hook Old Timers Day. I missed this last one. I love to see my Red Hook family and friends. I'm thanking Delia for giving me this opportunity to reminisce going back 50 years. God bless you all, my Red Hook family and friends. Signing off, Elba Rosario.
Let's see. My memories of Red Hook. My name is Darius D. Johnson. I was better known as Dion Tate back in the day. I and my sisters Ellery and Pamela Tate lived at 70 Bush Street, apartment 1D. Our neighbors were Dawn and Darlene Scott, Edna and Carol. Edna is better known as Queen Bee Shabazz. And Portia Hamilton, who passed away a couple of years ago. I ran around with Jackie Jackson and Vicki Bush and her family. Lived next door to A. Bush, the Land, Pat and Andrew Land, the Phillips. Let's see, oh, so many. Myra, the Simmons, the Tripp, Rita and Sylvester and Stanley. And don't forget Donald Harper. Ooh, I had a serious crush on him. My memories of good memories I have of going to the pool, hanging out at the stadium, the PAL. We used to go on so many trips with the PAL. They got us out of Red Hook. And PS 27. My sisters and I, we would go there for lunch program and make plastic bracelets and whatnot. When we used to play the monkey bars, we used to play Coca Livia, and some had that added touch of Coca Livia Kiss Kiss Kiss. We used to play Red Light Green Light, you know, in the younger days. The Harriet, the twins, the Taylors, Stevie, Ivory, Bubbles and Dinkles and them. Oh my God. So she lives over there in the, what do they call ours? Lover's Lane, the Junkie Paradise. We had a bird's eye view of everything. We lived on the first floor, looked out the window on Lorraine Street, right across the street from the liquor store, the candy store, the dive store, and on and on and on. We saw all the drunks and the, we saw everything. We saw everything. Our windows over the ramp. We're facing Columbia Street where Mr. Johnny and them live. You can hang with Sharon Babor, Barbara Butts. I went to PS27 till the third grade. Then I was one of those guinea pigs for the busing situation. Was bused to PS169. Ooh, so many memories. You know, maybe not too many people may remember me, but I sure remember them. Boozy, Chapman and them. Real name was Roslyn. So many people passed on. I just can't stand it. I'm still in denial. Let's see, 42 years ago I left in 1972. But wow, me and my sister, Pamela was the more popular one. Ellery was the more stable one, and she was popular too, but Pamela was the one that was real popular. I was hanging out with the folks, put it that way. We used to go to Red Hook Gospel Assembly with Pastor Hopkins and them, and Charlotte Taylor and Naomi. That's how we got real closer to the Chavises and Donald Hall and them. Mr. Bobby used to come to my house all the time because my mother was associated with the number situation. So she, so many mothers would come to my house, come to our house and place the number. So with that in mind, memory. Growing up in Red Hook, I left in 1972, but Red Hook never left me. I will always claim Red Hook, always claim Red Hook, and Red Hook will always claim me. Yeah.
that makes me want to shout. I got that thing, tell me what it's all about. I got soul, and I'm super bad. Got the move that tells me what to do. Sometimes I feel so nice, I said I want to try myself with you. In the morning, before noon.
Right on, brother. Make it soon. In the evening, I get my groove. Got my soul. I got the move. I got it. I got it. I said I'm super bad. Super. Super bad. Super bad. Do your thing, Robert. Super bad. Train. Super bad. Super bad. Fellas. 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 I need some power. Soul power. Soul power.
Love y'all, Red Hook.